Nagaland Governor Laganay's son today inaugurated a water reservoir at Good Samaritan Senior Citizens Home, Marima, Nagaland, to ensure the well-being and comfort of the elderly residents. Speaking at the inauguration program, the Nagaland Governor says that the occasion is particularly close to his heart because of its significance and because it encompasses the spirit of care and respect towards the elderly community. Manipur Chief Minister N. Biren Singh stated that violence in the state has decreased, noting that the crisis occurred over 6 to 7 months within a 14-month period. He expressed optimism that a solution would be reached in 2 to 3 months. Singh emphasized that despite ongoing violence in other places, schools and business in Manipur have reopened, indicating a return to normalcy. The Delhi High Court today said the trial court order granting bail to Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal shall not be given effect to till it hears the ED's plea challenging the relief granted in the money laundering case linked to the alleged excise scam. The Enforcement Directorate ED mentioned its plea challenging the trial court order for an urgent hearing before a bench of Justices Sudhir Kumar Jain and Ravinder Dudeja, which said the case file would come to ED in 10 to 15 minutes and after that it will hear the matter. The CBI registered an FIR into the UG Net paper leak case on Thursday, June 20, against unidentified persons on a reference form the Union Education Ministry officials said. The next day, UG received inputs from the National Cybercrime Threat Analytics Unit that the paper was available on the darknet and was allegedly sold for 5 to 6 lakh on messaging platforms. Sikkim celebrated archer Tarundeep Rai will represent India in the men's recurve team at the upcoming Paris Summer Olympics 2024, representing the country on one of the world's biggest sporting stages. Born on February 22, 1984 in Namchi, South Sikkim, Tarundeep Rai comes from a state in the Himalayan foothills in India. His cousin, Indian football legend Bijing Bhutia, famously put Sikkim on India's sporting map. The influential sister of North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un today hinted about launching more trash-carrying balloons into South Korea as she condemned human scum for sending what she described as dirty waste paper and things. On Thursday night, a North Korean defectors group sent 20 balloons carrying some 300,000 leaflets, US dollars and USB sticks containing a hit K-drama and songs across the border in the border city of Paju, the latest in a series of tit-for-tat leaflet campaigns between the two Koreas, reports Yonhap News Agency. The third edition of the AIFF Futsal Club Championship is set to kick off at the Swarnim Gujarat Sports University tomorrow. 19 teams will battle for 16 days to make it to the final and lift the trophy on July 7th. They have been divided into four groups, Group A, B and C with 5 teams each and Group D with 4 teams. The top 2 teams in each group will qualify for the quarter-finals.